Father Steve was my pastor, my spiritual guide, my teacher and counselor, my confessor and my friend.
He was a dear friend and he will be greatly missed.
What a gift to be able to experience his presence.
He blessed every one of us by what he said and what he did.
We'll miss him.
Yeah.
Well, my favorite thing about Father Steve was probably his homilies.
He was a perfect patron, patron of the arts.
And he could do all of this with ease and grace.
He was a holy man. He walked the walk. He never preached down to anybody, never judged anybody. He was just his absolute diamond. I loved him dearly. It was an honor to be with him when he was going through his starting of death.
He had this ability to really cut through things and to see it clearly.
He could always listen to all of us and all the things that were going on and then just cut to the quick and have an answer, and we'd all look at each other and say, of course, that's what we were supposed to be doing or what was supposed to happen.
Everybody knew how knowledgeable he was, but the insight he could provide on anything related to the school or mentoring me was a gift.
What Steve had, besides that brilliant mind of his, he had a gift of common sense that a lot of people who are intelligent don't have that. He had it so much, it was unbelievable.
My wonderment is how this skinny little man could do all he did and climb mountains besides.
So after a good 4 to 6 mile run on New Year's Day, we'd just have a lot of fun visiting. But one of these New Year's Day runs, Father Steve had calculated that he had accumulated enough miles that he was going to, that day, break the distance around the circumference of the earth, which is like 24,900 and some miles. He had it exact, of course. So we set up a finish line tape out in the street, and we took several photos of Father Steve ahead of all the other kids on the cross country team and these college runners that had come back, and he's beating them all to the tape.
He has his hands, we have the tape pulled across the road, and so Steve's running, and Matt Winter, who was the fastest kid in the state that year, was behind Steve coming across the finish line.
And he's got his arms in the air in glory. I think Father Steve really appreciated the time with the kids, all the energy and enthusiasm that they generated.
From my littlest days up until now, I could always go to church and know there'd be one smiling face there to trust on. His sense of humor and kindness truly will never be beat by anyone else.
And he actually went to the state tournament with us in Bozeman last year. And in a loser out game, we were about 9 for 30 from the free throw line, and I was a little bit heated walking up and down the sideline, and I made the comment, somewhat emotional, is there anybody on this bench that can make a free throw? And Father Steve, in just his perfect demeanor and very quietly raised his hand and said, well, I think I can if you'll check me in. And so it was a great moment, calmed me down instantly, put things in perspective, and that's a memory I will cherish, was having him with us side by side. And that legacy will continue. If you watch our basketball program this year, there'll be a seat on the bench always for Father Steve. So,
you know, it's a delight to hear the kids on the playground every day. It's a delight to celebrate Mass with them weekly. Just had Mass this morning, to visit the classrooms, not just here at St. Pius, but I get pretty involved at the high school as well. And it's a source of energy and delight for me. To say that.
I will be forever grateful, for he brought me to trust and to love.
The one quality that he has taught me most in life was the quality of being a good listener and never saying no to something without hearing it all the way through.
He had a tremendous gift of listening, and whether you were talking to him one-on-one or in a large group, he was paying attention to what you said.
He offered some really great, clear-cut objectives, some real meaningful insights, and then he let the artists do their work.
And as I listened to the many witnesses at his vigil and funeral, it was clear that he had a universal appeal and a universal love.
And I was just sitting by his bed, and I said, are you scared? And he says, you mean to die? And I says, yeah. And he says, no, I'm not afraid of death at all. And he says, is there three of us in here? I keep hearing somebody else talking. And I said, no, buddy, it's just you and me. I look back now, and I do think there might have been a third one in there. If it wasn't the Holy Spirit, it was a good friend of the Holy Spirit, because there was so much peace between us there that can only came from there.
It was his relationship with God, his trust in God, and his love for God. Thank you. Thank you.